This page was created to teach black history. Unfortunately, the American educational system was designed to exclude our real historical account. So we are here to dismantle it. It's time to enlighten those of us who have been kept in the dark. I am a black man who didn't know enough about my own history. So I began to dig deeper and do my own research. Black history is American history. So I want people of all races and cultures to join together to learn our history as one. Here, I will share all of my findings. Please like, follow, share, and subscribe to Teaching Black History. The story of Henry Bibb. Bibb was born to an enslaved woman, Mildred Jackson, on Catalonia, Kentucky, plantation on May 10th, 1815. His people told him his white father was James Bibb, a Kentucky state senator, but Henry never knew him. As he was growing up, Bibb saw each of his six younger siblings, all boys, sold away. In 1833, Bibb married another enslaved mulatto, Melinda, who lived in Oldham County, Kentucky. They had a daughter, Mary Frances, in 1842. He managed to flee to Detroit from where he hoped to gain the freedom of his wife and daughter. After finding out that Melinda had been sold as a mistress to a white planter, Bibb focused on his career as an abolitionist. He traveled and lectured throughout the United States. In 1849, he published his autobiography, Narrative of the Life and Adventures of Henry Bibb, an American Slave, which became one of the best-known slave narratives of the antebellum years. The passage of the Fugitive Slave Act of 1850 increased the danger to Bibb and his second wife, Mary Miles. It required Northerners to cooperate in the capture of escaped slaves. To ensure their safety, the Bibbs migrated to Canada. In 1851, he set up the first black newspaper in Canada, The Voice of the Fugitive. The paper helped develop a more sympathetic climate for blacks in Canada, as well as helped new arrivals to adjust. Due to his fame as an author, Bibb was reunited with three of his brothers, who separately had also escaped from slavery in Canada. In 1852, he published their accounts in his newspaper. He died on August 1st, 1854, at Winslow, Canada West, at the age of 39.